Okay, that's it. I'm fed up. This interactive movie crap has gone far enough.
What are you whining about now?
Flash Traffic, City of Angels from Tsunami and Time Warner. It's a bad cop movie wasting 3 CD-ROMs worth of space.
Okay, calm down. Isn't this the game that describes itself as an all-video interactive techno thriller? I mean, that sounds pretty cool.
Yes, it's all video. So is A Current Affair. So is Family Feud. Does that make it worthwhile programming?
But Flash Traffic is also interactive. Surely that's worth the money.
Yeah, right. Flash Traffic is as interactive as a choose-your-own-adventure book.
I'm sensing some hostility here. What's the story of Flash Traffic?
Well, there's a guy who's made his own H-bomb from household materials, and you, the FBI guy, have to find it somewhere in Los Angeles.
Sounds pretty good so far.
What do you mean, so far? That's it. That's your 3 CDs worth of game.
Okay, but there could be a lot of excitement in that premise. You know, a race against time, an unpredictable maniac, and then...
Trust me, you don't want to use the word unpredictable anywhere in connection with this game. That's what I'm talking about with the interactive movie stuff. A lot of game designers seem to think that movie has to mean the cranked out formula pictures that Hollywood loves to fill our video stores with.
So you're saying that Flash Traffic is not exactly the French Connection? Is that what you're saying?
Yes, that's exactly what I'm saying. Flash Traffic is more like The Rookie or The Hard Way, especially when it comes to dialogue. Compared to these characters, Joe Friday comes off sounding like Voltaire.
You know, this sounds a lot like the reaction you had to the Psychotron a few months back.
Ah, yes. I'd almost managed to forget the Psychotron. A lot of video, a lot of pathetic writing, and 5 hours of play tops. But you know what? Flash Traffic is genuinely worse.
Okay, you can't just make a statement like that without backing it up.
Well, however painful Psychotron was, at least the video quality was really good, and it only took up one CD. I played through Psychotron in about 4 hours. It only took me 2.5 to finish Flash Traffic, and it takes up...
I know. 3 CDs.
And just look at this picture quality. I know the technology is still new and has a long way to go, but I have seen much, much better than this. The whole game feels like you're looking at it through a screen door.
Oh, I don't know. It doesn't look that bad. I've heard some very good things about the MPEG version. Besides, it's almost impossible to get a sharp image onto a PC from video.
Yeah, but these guys were so determined to stick with video that they even held up the pertinent documents to the camera instead of giving you a nice legible text file.
Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. I'm looking at the world through fly eyes.
And even considering the sad and simple engine, there's still a lot of segment looping that should never take place in a, quote, race against time.
Excuse me? There are laymen in the audience.
Okay. This guy needs to be convinced to talk, and the best way is to fool him into thinking he's radioactive. He gets a red clip put on his shirt, and he seems to be much more eager to talk. But if you ask the wrong question, he gets his pre-nuke attitude back, and the same video plays again. The red clip is even gone again.
You mean you have to ask the same questions all over again to get back where you were? Boy, that sounds intensely annoying.
This thing was really produced on the cheap to try to get a piece of the multi-CD game action. It's riding on the coattails of Under a Killing Moon and Phantasmagoria, and that makes me a bit ill.
Yeah, I see what you mean. Forget the fact that other games involved several years of production and very sophisticated graphics. We're charging the same amount for what we made with our camcorder in less time than it takes Hollywood to make a new Police Academy movie.
So now, do you see why I'm upset about Flash Traffic?
Sure. If this game actually manages to sell a lot, it'll convince the makers that it's a good idea to keep doing pathetic things like this.
And that would be a pretty sad state of affairs for the industry, wouldn't it?
You're darn tootin'. We can't let that happen. Folks, don't buy Flash Traffic. We've got to send a message to Washington. Time Warner. We're as mad as hell, and we're not going to take it anymore.
Very nice. FM with a touch of Jimmy Stewart.